All right, welcome everybody, both everyone who is here in person and for anyone joining us virtually. What a great way to start our week as seniors, graduation week. Just a few things before we get started. If you need to use the restroom, we have bathrooms out those doors. And a reminder that we will have refreshments after this is over through those doors. So stick around. And with that, get ready for an awesome service.
We're going to start with the opening prayer here, so if you can please bow your heads and pray with me. Dear Lord, we thank you for bringing us all here safely and giving us the ability to be here today, honoring you and these seniors. We pray for the food that we have been blessed with today, that it nourishes us and fills us with your spirit. We pray that we may gather some of your wisdom today and that we may carry it with us in the next phase of our lives. We pray that you may protect us as we go on, and that we may serve you through our new lives. And lastly, we pray for everyone's health and safety in these still uncertain times. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Thank you so much for the opening prayer. Thank you for the welcome. The praise team welcomes you also. We invite you to stand. We'd like to sing together a couple worship songs. This first one's Graves into Gardens, and Riley's going to lead us through it.
The world, but it couldn't fill me. A man's empty praise and treasures that fade are never enough. But you came along and put me back together.
Yeah.
Matthew Riley in choir. We also have Chain Breaker. This is Sophia. Thank you so much.
Isaiah 58, verse 10 through 11. If you do away with the yoke of oppression, with the pointing finger and malicious talk, and if you spend yourselves in behalf of the hungry and satisfy the needs of the oppressed, then your light will rise in the darkness, and your night will become like the noonday. The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land and will strengthen your frame. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail.
I'll be reading 1 Timothy 4, 12 through 16. Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. Until I come, devote yourself to the public reading of Scripture, to preaching and to teaching. Do not neglect your gift, which was given you through prophecy when the body of elders laid their hands on you. Be diligent in these matters. Give yourself wholly to them so that everyone may see your progress. Watch your life and doctrine closely. Persevere in them, because if you do, you will save both yourself and your hearers.
Good afternoon, I guess. It's still light outside, right? How are we doing? You guys are dead. This is crazy. In a week from today, we will be graduated. We'll be done with high school. We'll be on to the next chapter of our lives, which is insane to me. I still can't believe it. But here we are. And I'm here today, and I'm assuming the rest of you are here today because we all believe in the same God. And I hope we can keep that in mind as we get through this message today. And I also want to put in there that today's message that I've planned for today is not a warm and fuzzy message or anything that you're probably going to want to hear. I'm going to tell you what you don't want to hear because I believe that's how we grow. So here we are. I am also going to say I'm nervous because I'm not used to preaching to my classmates. So I've always been a very firm believer in living in this world but not conforming to it. And I've used that in previous messages. I've been preaching since about sophomore year of high school, and I've always used that in messages here and there, just saying, you know, live in this world but don't conform to it. But I never truly grasped that idea for myself until the end of around 2020. And once I realized what I had been doing, I was starting to questioning where my priorities were at. You see, I had realized that for half of my devotion of my life, I had been giving to the world. Part of my life, I was living for the world, but the other part of my life, I was living for Christ. I wasn't, you know, completely neglecting my faith by any means, but there were some aspects of my life where I was living for the world. And what that puts me in a place of is divided loyalty. And if we don't necessarily understand what divided loyalty is, think about all the times that we've been stressed out in school. We've got homework to do, practice, class, family, friends, we get to go to the game, you know, we have all these things that we need to give our time to, and we feel stretched thin. And I know we've all felt that feeling because I've been in classes and been in school with all of you in here for about 6 years now, and I know we've all felt that. We've felt that feeling of being stretched thin, like we can't give enough of our time to all the priorities in our life. So my question to you all today is, why are we doing that with our faith? Because I know I'm not the only one. We humans are a lot more alike than we seem. Why are we doing that with our faith? Why are we compromising our faith for the desires of this world? And it's a question we have to answer for ourselves. It's a question I had to answer for myself. And I also realized that when I was thinking about these things, I've realized that our world and what we know is truth, the world has gone in a completely opposite direction of what truth is. It's been running in the opposite direction for 2,000 years now. And let me tell you, this world and the things of this world are sprinting in the opposite direction of what we have grown up and known as truth. And whenever we're living our lives half for the world and half for God, or 75-25, I don't know where you're at, we're slowly being stretched thinner and thinner. And we're going like this. And it reminds me a little bit of water skiing. It's a weird analogy, but if you've ever water skied or seen someone water ski, you know it's really important to keep your feet together. You can't let your feet get too far apart because then you'll face plant in the middle. You see, this world is going further and further and further away from our faith, and whenever we've got our feet in both worlds, we're stretching thinner and thinner, and soon we're going to fall down somewhere in the middle, and that's where we're going to find doubt. That's when we're going to find temptation. That's when we're going to find fear. And if you don't believe me, look at our world. We live in a world where you can type whatever you want on social media, comment, text, whatever you want to someone, like they mean nothing to you. Not saying that you yourself have done it, but you've seen it done to other people. We live in a world where we glorify sin and we cancel faith. We live in a world where the ideas of love have become twisted. We live in a world that is so full of division and hate, it's not even funny. We cannot continue to divide our loyalties between this world and our faith. But I know it's hard. Trust me. I think it's one of the hardest parts of being a Christian is maintaining that balance of living in the world but not conforming to it, because it's tempting. This world is full of temptation. It's tempting to scroll through TikTok instead of reading our Bibles. It's tempting to use foul language because all the songs we listen to say it and all of our friends are saying it. It's tempting to have premarital sex because everyone in high school has done it. Everyone on the internet is doing it. Next year, when we go off to college or wherever life takes us, it's going to be tempting to go to a party and get drunk or do something that we're going to regret later on because everyone else is doing it. It looks like a lot of fun. It's tempting to live in this world, but it's also hard to live without love. It's hard to live in fear. It's hard to live without knowing joy. It's hard to live without Jesus. So why are we compromising our faith for the desires of this world? And I'm not up here today to tell you to completely disconnect yourself from this world, because we are called to live in this world. We're just not to conform to it. Because if we're not living in this world, then we're not spreading God's word. That's what Jesus did. He walked alongside sinners, and he was still able to spread God's word, and he was still able to resist temptation. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about some truth that Jesus followed, because he never compromised truth. So we're going to start in James 1, and I believe we're going to pull it up on the screen. There we go. James 1, verse 6 reads, "But when you ask, make sure that your faith is in God alone. Do not waver, for a person with divided loyalty is as unsettled as a wave of the sea blown and tossed by the wind. Such people should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Their loyalty is divided between God and the world, and they are unstable in everything that they do." And skipping down to James 1:12, it says, "And remember, when you are being tempted, do not say, 'God is tempting me.' God is never tempted to do wrong, and he never tempts anyone else. Temptation comes from our own desires, which entice us and drag us away. These desires give birth to sinful actions, and when sin is allowed to grow, it gives birth to death." And lastly, in John 12:25, "Those who love their life in this world will lose it. Those who care nothing for their life in this world will keep it for eternity." This is not a matter of life or death. We're not on this world to one day die and just be dead. When we die, we will come before our Father in heaven, and he will either say to us, "Depart from me, for I did not know you," or, "Well done, good and faithful one." This is not a matter of life or death. This is a matter of life or eternity. And when we have these divided loyalties, we become something called lukewarm. And if you haven't heard about lukewarmness, we find out about lukewarm in Revelation, so that's how we know it's serious. In Revelation 3:15, it says, "I know your deeds, that you are neither hot nor cold. I wish you were either one or the other. So because you are lukewarm, I will spit you out of my mouth." It is very hard to live in this world and be living for this world and be on fire for Jesus. It is very hard to be living in this world and have a strong faith and to be hot for Jesus. It's very easy to be living for this world and be lukewarm. But we don't want to be lukewarm, because then we're going to be spit out of Jesus' mouth. I don't know about you, but the only mouth I want to be spit out of is the devil's. So we have to stop living for the world, and we have to start relying on God. But I can't make you understand that today unless you're ready to understand that for yourself, unless you're ready to challenge yourself and to dig deep. But I want to give you some advice that it starts with relationship. You see, my faith is founded upon relationship. I think a lot of the times we get it a little bit twisted, and we think that our faith and that our religion is about obedience. And obedience is a very big part of what we believe in and our faith. But I believe that obedience alone is weak when faced with temptation. You see, next year, wherever life takes us, maybe even in this summer, when you're faced with temptation, I personally do not believe it's enough to just obey God and say, "I want to obey God." For me, I need to have relationship with my Father in heaven, so that will drive obedience for me, that will drive passion, that will drive a want to follow him and a want to obey him. Obedience alone is weak when faced with temptation. In that relationship, it doesn't just help you through temptation. That relationship is going to get you through some of the hardest battles you will ever face in your life. But a relationship with this world will not. This world will let you down time and time again because, like I said, it's full of hate and division. It might tell you that it's going to give you love. This world might tell you it's going to bring you joy. It might tell you it's going to bring you peace. But every single thing you come into contact with in this world is fleeting. Everything in this world is fleeting. One day it will all be gone, and if we don't have our faith, we have nothing left. So we have to be grounded in our faith today. It starts today. That relationship starts today. I don't know about you all, but I want to live an eternity with my Father in heaven. And I want to obey God along the way, and I want to live my life for Christ, not because I'm expected to, but because if a God who would send his only son to die on a cross for me, a sinner, if Jesus thought I was worth dying for, he is surely worth living for. So let's stop compromising our faith. If you are right now, and maybe you haven't realized it, or maybe you don't think you are, if you aren't compromising your faith, that's great. But I want to encourage you and challenge you that the next time that you're maybe sitting at home on TikTok or Instagram, whatever you're doing on social media, on your phone, and you don't have anything else to do, get out in your Bible and just start reading it. Next time you're in the car, turn on the Christian radio. Next time you feel temptation, even if you don't think it's temptation, pray. And if you haven't already, please start that relationship with God. Start that relationship with Jesus because it is the best decision you will ever make in your entire life. And it will give you a strength that will take you through this next season of life, that will guide you. And whenever we have that relationship, we don't have to have fear. We have confidence. We don't have to have any feelings of doubt because we have peace. And once we stop running towards the world and start running towards our God, enemies flee. Darkness turns to light. People notice something is different about you, and you're able to bring more people to Jesus. We could fill this room full of people if every single one of us was on fire for Jesus, because I guarantee you, someone would notice that something is different about you, and you can tell them about Jesus. And you can bring them to Jesus. And we could fill this room. We could fill a million rooms if we could all just be on fire for Jesus. But it starts whenever we stop living for this world. We are to live in this world and not conform to it. And we are to have a faith without any divided loyalties. Let's pray. Father God, I thank you for the ability to get before my peers today and preach to them, God. I pray that no matter what, that they would learn to love you, that through this next season of life that you would guide them, that you would watch over them. God, we know that you say that you have plans to prosper us, that you will not harm us, you will never forsake us, God, and we trust you. We trust you to guide us through this next season of life, that we trust you to love us and take care of us. But God, I pray that everyone in this room would choose to live for you and to stop living for the world. And I pray that you would bring them love and peace, and I ask these things all in your name. Amen.
And amen. Hey, we are going to continue our service with cookies. Yay. Okay. So the cookie ladies have informed me that they want us to go enter through that door, okay, that Pastor Clayton is opening right now, and exit through this door, and then you can come back out with your refreshments. And when we get everybody pretty much out here, we'll dim the lights and be ready for the video. Okay. So start with the seniors. Oh, perks already. Good job. Start with the seniors. So
of God, we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Yeah, forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Depths of the sea, creations revealing your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring, every creature unique in the soul that it. You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing. And all powerful, untamable, awestruck, we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim. You are amazing. Told every lightning bolt where you should go, or seen heavenly storehouses laden with snow.
There we go. Okay, well, I'm the closer for today, and I was informed that there were plenty of cookies still left in the hall, so if you would like to take some for the road, then please do. Let's bow our heads. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day that we may be together. Thank you for protecting us and bringing us safely out of the pandemic. We pray today for our class, our families, our community, and our world, that we may remember those who lost their lives in the past year. We pray for your protection today as we go forward, Father, to serve you. All these things we pray in your holy name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. All right, go get those cookies, please.